Hello, everyone. Welcome back to more Alundra. We are here in a dream. Giles' dream. That's how we move that block. And we definitely want to go to the right here. There's a switch here, and there's a switch on the other side too, but when you press it, all that happens is the floor falls out from under you, and we don't want that. Pressing the one on the right gives us access to this area. And this area is much nicer than a hole in the floor. But it does have shadows, which we must defeat before we can continue on. So I'll use my charged up shot to kill all of them, and it's always this last shadow. This last shadow is always just taking forever to spawn, and then it hits me and cancels out my charge. Come on, spawn again. There. That wasn't so bad, was it? No. We have this room full of these things. We need to hit them, and it is timed. And I'm going the wrong way. Because see, you can't go... Yeah, I screwed it up. You can't go back behind this area because there's a hole there that the game developers put there to trick you if you thought you could go that way. But you can't go that way because then you will fall in the hole. That's not good. And once you've hit all of them, the exit opens and we get a teleporter right here. Now in this area, you see the path over there, and you see this little stone with a face. Pass in front of his eyes and it blocks the area off. Same thing for that one. So we want to head back through this door instead before we do anything. And there are rocks here, oh my god! Dangerous. This place is not safe. Giles is trying to kill us in his dream because he thinks we are responsible for everything that's happened. Here we have another light pillar, I guess you could call them. I really don't know what to call these things, but we have another puzzle involving them that requires you to hit them in the correct order. Only way to really know how to do that is just trial and error. It lifts up these blocks, and you kind of have to hurry because the blocks will go back down. And hold left! Hold left when you fall down, because otherwise you will go farther down, and we don't want to go down there. We could. There are chests down there that have herbs, and that's nice, but there's a Gilded Falcon here, and we want that. We also want this ice block. Now we're back here in this room. Definitely want to avoid the statues again, because we need to not have our path blocked off, so because we don't want to go back in a circle. Anyways, that's where the ice block goes. They go on those little pillars, and they tend to spawn holes right under you. But holes are where we want to go. We want to fall in those holes to get to bigger and better places. And now we're waiting because there are more shadows. Shadows for us to kill. A lot of kill rooms in this dungeon. Combat isn't really as bad as the reptile lair, though. There's our ice block. And we can jump out of the way if we want to, but there's really no sense in it. But I did it anyway, just to prove I could. And now we are here. Yeah, you saw that area up above. Yep, we definitely need to get there. But I fell on purpose because there's somewhere else we need to go first. And that's in this room. This room has a tiny little maze of sorts. And our goal is to reach that treasure chest there in the middle. Which is not too difficult. But we want that chest. We want it because it contains a life vessel. That gives us 23 health. We're doing pretty good. Doing pretty well as far as health is concerned. Who's screaming? I just have to ask, who is the one screaming in all of these dreams? In all of the dreams, always screaming. I don't know why. I don't know who. I don't know, but you see those two statues there and that fireball. Yeah, those are important to remember. Not important as other statues, but no, it's important. Take this teleporter. And now we're all the way back here. So I'll be back in 1 second whenever I get back to where we need to be. Jump and hold up. Hold up! Yay, we got here. And hey, it's 2 statues and a fireball. Coincidence? No. It's not a coincidence. We have 2 more of these Sarah monsters to kill. And we need to avoid the fireball while doing so. There we go, that wasn't hard. Now we're on this place and we can jump here. And we can use bombs to blow up there, but as I recall, there's just a wonder essence in there. But now you see the path here has been unblocked. Now that we've killed those 2 Sarah monsters, and we come to this puzzle. Can you guess what's gonna happen? Can you guess what is going to happen? If you can't, it's one of these puzzles. One of these puzzles where you have to press all of the switches, and that is how you solve it. It is very easy. Very, very easy. People make those puzzles out to be harder than they really are. Not all of them can be solved like that, obviously, but yeah, still. Okay. We want to head here. We want to go this way. We want to do this puzzle, and this puzzle is kind of annoying. This is one of those timed puzzles, and this time you have to be pretty much perfect with your execution. We need to press all 3 of these switches before time runs out, and time is not very lenient. But hey, I did it on the first try, that's pretty great. And those are spikes. Do you see those spikes? Those are spikes. They're not instant kill. Nothing is actually instant kill in this game, save for a few things, but we actually want to fall down this hole in the middle. Hey, look where we are, we're right on top of an ice block. And these things. I hate these things. I think I've mentioned this before. These things, I don't like them. Always exploding in a bunch of bomb things. It's annoying. It's annoying and I don't like them. There. Now we've killed them all. Now we can continue on. Well, These fall down, then move, and then fall down again. Kind of an odd type of pattern thing, but that's what they do. Now down here is another kill room. Kind of seems like there's a lot of combat recently, but I don't know. I still don't consider it as bad. Kill rooms in this area usually only have like 4 enemies or so. Kill rooms in the reptile lair had like 80 in every room. I think the room full of reptiles is more annoying than the room full of these things. Okay, that kills all of those, and that's opened up a door right here. And hey, look! Herbs are here, and it didn't explode into herbs for some reason. I don't really know why. But hey, look, we've re-entered the room, and now there are shadows. And it's another kill room, this time with shadows. I'm just gonna run into fireballs. I think that's my strategy for killing these shadows. Running into fireballs. Sounds like a good plan to me. Where'd the last one go? Oh, there he is. Come on, it's always this last one that takes forever to spawn. Spawn, there you go. Now you're dead. Look what happens when you spawn, you die. Oh, great. Something's happening. Yeah, who didn't see this coming really now? Show of hands, who didn't see all the statues coming to life and becoming monsters? Yeah, I expected it too. And show of hands, who expects that we now have to kill every single one of these Sarah monsters in order to progress? If you are raising your hand, you are currently correct. So there are 6 Sarah monsters, and we need to kill all of them. Luckily, the two at the door actually don't come to life, which is kind of a surprise, but definitely a welcome surprise, because, yeah. You know, the fewer monsters I have to kill, the better off I am. Combat in Alundra really isn't that difficult, as you can tell. With these monsters, it's just a matter of timing your hits. You can't swing too early or it won't hit them, and you can't swing too late or else they'll disappear before you can hit them. Screw you guys. Now we are here, and next time on Let's Play Alundra, we have more things to do. I'm Vega, I will see you then.